Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, this is WhipdaDash, and I'm doing what we call the Parabellum mod for Mount Blade Warband. And here today, I'm going to show you some of the mod, just a little preview clip on. This mod does have a few bugs here and there, but over and all, this thing has a wonderful gameplay setting for fun, shits and giggles, as I call it. As you can see, the scenery of the mods is broken down. We're in the World War One era post, I believe, of something of that sort. As you can see, the airplanes and tanks that are soaring. Now watch this. I'm going to call in an airstrike right down there. And hopefully I don't destroy my own shit. And I'm going to be using the health mod just for the benefit of this video. Oh, wow, I'm getting snapped. What the hell's shooting at me? Now, as you can see, those are my two planes. You see these wonderful tanks. These tanks are now considered to be units. You can only have so many on the field at one time. Not a bad way to kind of balance the game. You don't want 4, 5, 50 tanks out there wiping you out, yeah. Because these are some powerful tanks. Ooh, we won that battle. Nice, nice, nice. Look at my nice little armor here. You would say this is World War armor. This is more like, you know, survivalist here. And I am sieging, one of my favorite things to do, on the Mountain Blade series, is obviously the siege, and I love to find out the visual effects, the realism. And obviously I'm taking a little bit of realism of using some cheats here. And you can see all that script bugging. Yeah, it's got a couple bugs, but overall this game has really surprised me in some of the things and the aspects that it's given. Just the modern guns. We're talking Mountain Blade here in the medieval times, and we've turned this game into a complete, I want to say conversion, complete full conversion of the Mountain Blade series, almost. I mean, you can still get probably swords and pole arms, I'm sure. Now, why is my tank, is my tank really stuck in that thing? Yeah, he's not really thinking. As you can see, I got my Rolls-Royce armored cars just moving up the line there, and I want to push up there. There's a trench. Trench fighting here is awesome, as you're soon about to find out. Now, obviously, I didn't have my graphics in H definition, so sorry, guys. Apologize. But there are people out there who have bigger, you know, space and hard drive space and bigger processors than I do. Obviously, I'm using a laptop, so that's not saying much. Oh, anywho, back on the battlefront here. Now, I'm wondering if I can call in an airstrike over there. I think that would be a good idea, because anywhere I point is where it's going to call in one. There it comes. And obviously, you got to have some howitzers. You have to buy them from a special. I'll do that in maybe some later more videos when people want to get a little bit more information gameplay wise. Here they are. They're all nestled in this trench. I'm going to execute them old fashioned style. Oh, yeah, buddy. Oh, look at that. Just there you go. Take them all out. I wonder why it's not letting me. Oh, dude, get off me. Okay, I better get out of this trench, because. Yeah, sorry, soldiers. You fought well today, but you failed. Goodbye. Now, I was trying to sit there and use my weapon as a melee weapon. Obviously, I can't do that. Hey, little bastard. Oh, yeah. That'll just kick you to death. Fuck you. Yeah, right in the chin. How about you like that? How do you like that? Oh man, I saw that. Question is, how many more guys do we have here in the trenches? There we go. Seems that aiming doesn't seem to help in this fact. I can just, you know, practically blind fire. Now, as we're moving up, we're going to move up to that village up there, that town. That's where they're going to be spawning out of. Now, I wonder if that's my plane, because I don't know if that's my plane. I don't know if they said that was my plane or not. I don't think that's my plane. Red planes don't look like mine. Though I did buy a bunch of them. I can't really tell what's mine. But anyways, whatever. As long as they're not hurting me, I don't care. Let's see if we can peek out this window and see anybody. Now, I would say this would be an awesome multiplayer mod. Also, it would take quite a few fixes, but over and all, I don't think that this would be a continued mod, and I'm not really... Oh, wow. Is that really my plane coming down? That's my plane. Completely my plane. Yeah, they shot down my plane. I'm not happy about that. Look at the size of that thing. Oh, wow. Now hopefully the enemy is not calling airstrikes on my stuff, because he could take out my Rolls Royces real quick. We can kind of look at, see what I've got units wise. We got 6 on the battlefield. Wow. 29 dead. Wait, this is going to be a minute. Oh, yeah. We've got over 300 soldiers to watch out for. I'm going to have to go figure out where my enemies are at, because I think I'm the only soldier. My tanks are over here blistering him. It's alright, guys. Just keep on knocking down the numbers here. I don't care. I'm pretty sure it was up here. Yeah, my video kind of cut out when I was kind of changing some graphic effects. Let's see if I can add some more detail. I don't know why my explosions aren't popping up in here. Maybe I'll get a little help on that later on. Right over there in that fence line. There it is. So you know what? We are going to call in the airstrike over there and see how it fares up. Oh, I got one troop. Oh, Rolls Royce over there just wiping them all out. Look at him. Look at him. I got 3 of them over there just doing the work. Oh, wow, I'm getting hit. Now, when my artillery is completely restocked, oh, he's got some weapon ammo on the ground. He saved me a bullet. Oh, so nice. Oh, wow. They're chunking my health out. They got some machine gunners over there. And I'll be quite, very detailed when I'm going to go through some more videos, hopefully, and kind of show some of the weapons on this game, as I can't just go and pop through my inventory bag right now, which if I, you know, stayed at home base. Oh, wow. Come on, guys. They just about wiped me out. Come on, get behind that fence. Fuck. Damn, shit. Back the fuck off. The fuck they hit me with, bricks? Okay, there we go. Get some cover here. As you can see, the game's real realistic when it comes down to cover. Accuracy seems to be quite an importance here, especially, you know, when you're picking a fight with these guys. Somehow they're hitting me. I guess my aiming's just not gonna work out. Oh, wow. Alright, boys. Hope you're ready for that. Oh yeah, new enemies have arrived. I think I need to get in a more strategic position. At least I'm gonna try. Come on, reload that pistol. Reload, reload. We're in a desperate situation here. Start popping caps. Come on, come on. Look at that little artillery round after effect right there, just hanging up in the sky. See, like I said, it's got a couple bugs, but overall, I think I can get around that. I would say this is one of my, I'll say in my top 5 mods. Overall, this game does not have any major bad things that I can find wrong with it so far. I mean, like I said, it's got a bunch of script bugs, but like I said, it could be worked on, and eventually somebody could take this and improve it if they wish. Of course, the Napoleonic Wars and the new updates that we've got for now, the Mount Blade series, this should be an easy fix. But before Bannerlord hits the realm, what are we going to do? Alright, boys. I think it's time to do what we thought. Look at that, they don't even know I'm here. Pop. That guy knows I'm here. Goodbye. I'm getting out of here before artillery shells start pounding. Good God. Come on, reload, reload, reload. I've got one bullet in the chamber here. One bullet. At least I hit somebody with it. Come on, 26 rounds left. I'm in so much shit. I wonder if there's any guys in here. Oh no, an abandoned house. Oh. You need to die, sir. I'm sick of you aiming at me. Come on, reload, reload, reload. Calling them shells. Let's see, watch them artillery. Ooh, look at that artillery just wipe them out. Look at that, the invisible hand takes them right out. Okay. I'm gonna go down here and see if I can finish him off. Fuck you, asshole. And I need ammo. Rifle ammo, rifle ammo. Cool beans. Now, I don't know what we're still waiting on to be destroyed. Oh, we got some soldiers over here. Goodbye. Sorry, guys. Got my Rolls Royces over here doing all the work. What's going on? What's going on, fellas? Okay. I want to know what is still left. Enemies. There are two enemies left at Sand. But where could they be? Oh, where could you be? Now, I don't know if what's going on here. Let's try this. Tell everybody to charge. Where are these guys at? Now I'm following this Royce over here. He's obviously going to lead me to the target, I'm hoping. He wouldn't be in that house, would he? Where are these guys at? Okay, I think we're just going to do this for the time being. There we go. Easy knockout, I found them. I'm not going to sit here and search the map for two little fuckheads. And let's continue. Oh, now we're going to the heart of the town. So this is kind of like, you know, just a quick preview of what sieging is like in Parabellum. Since I'm trying to capture this island, take it for myself. Start my own. Oh, wow. That guy didn't last very long. I got some machine gunners over here. Look at these guys. You know what? Take that. Headshot. I will take it. So, is that everybody? Nope. Shit. He's aiming right at me. Get out of the way. Alright, reload your gun. Let's just tell these guys to charge. See, now obviously some of the AI on here is a little bit bugged out. They're like running into walls. That I'm not a big fan of. So if I had to rate this mod, I'm going to just give this mod about 7 stars out of 10. If I'm really going to give it, it still needs work. But it's an alright mod. Like I said, I'm not going to put it down or anything. It's just, it needs lots of improvements, lots of fixes. As you see, my soldiers, I don't even know where they're going. We're just going to keep on walking the town until we find some... Oh! Now, can you imagine, you know, walking this whole town trying to look for somebody? Alright, buddy. Now, I'm even wearing some nice skilled armor here, and even that, I'm taking nice bullets from everybody. What's going on over here? What's going on over here? Yeah, I don't think so, buddy. The town center is yours, but the remaining defenders have retreated to the castle. What castle? It must fall before you can complete your victory. Well, let's go into the manor, or the mansion, I should say, and take out. Oh, wow. These guys are gonna beat on me this whole time? Are you serious? Till one of them gives me one of them shovels. Oh, wow. I don't think so. That's how we assassins do it back in the day here. Didn't even have to use a health cheat, thank God. These are my prisoners. Now, it doesn't seem that I lost a whole lot here. Still got my bombers. I guess I should go ahead and acknowledge and look what my vehicle's unit's like, because obviously I could not tell what was going on in the air. Those red airplanes, I guess, were my enemies. My companion, poor companion. My companions always get wounded. I never pay attention to them guys too much. Look at all them guns. Could use that if I can haul that kind of ammo. But as you can see, my inventory is pretty stocked up here. Well, there's some actual boots. I would like those boots, but what good would those do me? I don't know what a military shovel is. I'm going to have to, I want to say equip a melee weapon, but I don't have any room. Whatever. Come on, come on. Yeah, that's another thing about loading. The loading this mod is not very to my liking. I think old people fuck faster than that, but whatever. We're not back in the dial-up days. Oh, hey, dude, where's your... Oh, your head's on a plane. That's nice. We have taken trees. What do you wish to give it to? Of course I want to take it. I am now the lord of trees. And I overtook this, obviously, with a small army, knowing that, worst case scenario, I'll use the knock everybody unconscious button on my cheats. My nice little control F4, boom, 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 knock everybody out. But I didn't have to on that one, just a couple, and which is pretty nice. So I can either appoint my companion as the Lord, which or appoint a promise, isn't now just appoint her. Now, what shall we name this? Captain Kanaveral's Nation. We're just going to call this the Kanaveral Empire. How about that? Make something quick and easy. For recording's sake. Now, luckily, this city loves me, so because I did not hurt them, I hurt a bunch of villages, which I'm going to pay for in the end. Now, the only thing, and here's another thing about this mod, as you can see, reading this, I don't know how anybody, you're going to have to get a pair of reading glasses to read some of that just because of the layout. I'm pretty sure we can fix that. Now, it says I need to manage my garrison. I think what I'm going to do is give them 2 tanks. I can't obviously give them a lot. I don't have a lot of soldiers to hand out here, and I want to be very cautious of, I think we'll just give them a couple machine gunners, Some camel fighter. Oh, I think I'll just give him one of those. You know what? I think I'll just give him a tank too. Mercenary commando. Sniper. We can give them a couple of those guys. I'm not going to stock up deeply because obviously these guys have. I still need to build my own army up. So let's go to the city hall. Let's go talk to my advisor. Oh, you got some bodyguards? Oh, yeah, you're right. I gave those to you. Torque. Torque, you little whore. Now, obviously, she's a female, and look at this. I've actually given her a full set of army here. Look at that. She got that nice 1944 look going on, whatever you want to call that. But we're in the year of the 1918. We're around the times of the barons. At your service, sire. I'm like that you're calling me sire and wearing that helmet, man. Sir, I could appreciate. Sire, that's a... Says, I may offer you a word of advice, sir. It seems that your right to rule as an independent monarch is not sufficiently recognized, and this may bring us problems further down the road. Ooh, this is a nice political diplomacy thing that they've added in here. Says, it may be advisable to find another kingdom with whom you have shared interests and seek its recognition to establish yourself as an equal with Kalradia's kings. So, do you have any ideas? Oh, so you tell me all this, but you can't do nothing about it. Okay, well, whatever. Let's see here. I'll just give... Oh, I can't give that to her. Why? Because she owns a town, is that why? Or does she own all of them? Yeah, I don't think she's going to be much help in this situation. Yeah, there's none. I know. You don't have to tell me this. Well, there we go. And, we can go to the, here, weapon, visit the Lord's weapon. Now, see here, if you can read some of these, we got a Renault tank. I'm gonna have to restock on my machinery here, since I was giving it away. I think I've already bought the howitzers. Now, I don't know if that says I've got enough money or not, but we can just go here to the black market here, where the weapons are shown. Look at this. Look at these guns. Now, some of these guns are actually real. I mean, we were talking real. One of the guns you will notice is what we call the wonderful Browning automatic rifle. The bar. Oh my gosh, they have the bar. Yes, they do. Now, of course, here's your sword, lance. I'm obviously going to have to decide whether I want to use it. I'm going to go ahead and sell this top hat. I don't see me wearing that anywhere else until I get my inventory big enough. I just guess I'll keep that military shovel for shits and giggles, whatever. What kind of ammo is that? Machine gun ammo? I don't need that. I probably do need to use a better rifle, so I'll probably just put that in there and take the rifle. Actually, you know what? I've seen people use that rifle, so I think I'll just use that one. Yeah, I don't have any money, so we're just going to have to jack up my stock of money here. You say, what are you doing? You are totally taking the fun out of the game. I said, no, I'm not. I'm building my empire. It's like when, you know, you start out with Legos, you can have either a big bucket or a small bucket and work your way up or do whatever you want, whatever. Now I'm going to make sure that I'm not out of money. Make sure that I've pretty much got max stock on everything if I can. I'll build a prisoner tower. How about that? I don't have enough money for that. Oh, well, that will make sense. We'll go to the tavern here. We're going to need some more soldiers anyways. Good God. Everything's expensive around here, especially all that heavy tank machinery. You'll spend a good 50, 60 grand on just a bunch of planes. Oh, yeah. And like I said, you can only have so much. Wandering Skull. I don't want to talk to you. What is he going to do? Oh, I'll buy everybody. Let's increase my relation. The better my relation, the better things I will get out of this city. There's like nobody in this tavern. I think everybody just left when I besieged the place. Okay, let's go back to the weapons factory. Okay. Now, I think I have acquired a full max party of tanks and gadgets and gadgets. At least that's what I'm thinking. So you now have 5 howitzers. Oh, well, isn't that fancy? Look at this. The Kanaveral Empire has started, and I started it on this island, and here's the size of your map for this mod. Very quite large one. As you can see, there's very some similarities between the original Warband. You got Sargoth, Warcheg, but we're in a more Beluga, you know, Sumno, some of these, you know, cities that were here originally. Now, I think that just the mod was basically just to change the conversion of the units, more likely. But as you can see, I started taking over this nice little island, and I'm going to have to take over that fort. I'm going to have to make these little people happy somehow. Now, let's go down here. Oh, yeah. I don't even know how many tanks I've really got. I think I'm going to go ahead and camp here. I can recruit them. Oh, yeah. I'm probably going to use morale, but whatever. Change your officer's title of the military power. How will your male vassals be known? Oh, we'll just say they're still captains. Female vassals will be known as officers. Male vassals, we'll call them majors. Or major. Nice little additive on this mod. Modify my banner. Okay, I can't really do much. Select a book to read. Yeah, we can start on that. I need to wait here for some time. Let my guys heal up a little bit. The Serenid Empire offers you a peace agreement. What is your answer? The truce between Swadian Empire and Republic of Nords has expired. Oh, look at all these diplomacy things popping up. Kanaveral Empire and Serenid Empire have made peace. So tell me. Okay, so I don't know why they made peace with me. I was never at war with them. Since you have been awarded the right to carry a banner, your banner will signify your status and bring you honor. Which banner do you want to choose? Ooh, look at all these nice little banners. Look at all them swastikas. Oh, yeah, that's right. I think I like that one. That looks pretty. Pretty colorful. Here comes the fog setting in. So, here's our Serenid Empire, and I don't know why these guys made peace with me, considering I never had anything against them. But, whatever. Well, thank you guys for joining, and joining a little preview of this mod, and just a little bit of quick know-how on things of this mod that might be interesting to some of you guys out there who are interested in the World 1 era. I know there's some people who like the medieval style of the Dark Ages when rifles were beginning to enter the realm. So, thank you guys very much for joining us, and you guys all have a wonderful day, and thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Feedback is always wonderful, and like I said, I do not own any copyrights to anything, so all my stuff is pretty much everybody else's licenses and under, so they're all protected by them. So you all take a nice little break and go check this mod out if you ever get the chance, and hopefully you don't run into many problems as I did at the very beginning. So any questions, and you guys feel free to send them my way. Thank you guys very much.